As I watch the sun descending and the birds fly home to rest, in the hush when day is ending, that's the hour when I feel blessed. Smoking my pipe. Smoking my pipe. Like a whisper through the cornfield comes a gentle evening breeze. At the doorway of my cottage I recall old memories. Smoking my pipe. Smoking my pipe.
Hello, brothers and sisters of the Briar. Professor Jeremiah here, and welcome to the finale of 31 Pipes, 31 Tobaccos, and 31 Days. Day 31. Did you think we would make it? We did it. Just barely. I recall those days. I hadn't smoked this tobacco this whole week, waiting for this moment to be thoroughly enjoyed with you. But it has become a regular smoker for me, maybe even an every other day smoker, if not an everyday smoker. This blend we're going to get to in just a moment, but first I do want to show you this pipe. Is that not wonderful? Well, if you saw a little logo on the stem there, you might already know whose pipe it is. This is none other than another Northern Briar Ian Walker pipe. And this is the first Ian Walker, which I purchased. Interesting enough, this pipe came from my tobacco shop in Birmingham, Alabama, the Briary. At that time, I'm not certain, but I think they had just started carrying Ian Walker's pipes, and at least the price at that point seemed like it may have been an introductory price to Ian's pipes being at the Briary. I don't know, partly because later I couldn't really reach to the level of some of the prices there, and I will say, as much as I enjoy the shop and I recommend for you to go there, I had to go and search for Northern Briar pipes and other locations. I just couldn't afford them at that spot at that time. Not to say I would never purchase another one there. I will if I find it. Well, it's a one-of-a-kind really design. Maybe even if I saw this pipe there today with some of the prices, I would really have to figure out how I could do it. But wonderful smoker. Get a relight on this. If I can talk to you about this blend. How this blend came about. So let me tell you a little bit about how the blend came about. It's just happens that you just heard the bells chime on the clock. This blend came about from an email that John Pounder sent to me, Dale Piper. He said, EA Carey is running a special on their tobaccos. Never really heard of EA Carey. Didn't know much about their tobaccos, their shop. Definitely never purchased anything from them. So I thought I'd take a look. You know, if John's sending this email, there must be a reason. So, went to their site. Sure enough, they had a pretty decent price. I can't remember now what it was. May have been $5 or $5.99 for, was it 2 ounces or an ounce and a half? I can't even remember now. Well, that's bad, isn't it? Well, I saw a few blends there. So I thought, well, I'll order 4 blends. Never ordered anything from them before. It did take a little while to get to me. Kind of a mix up and a little bit of a disappointment there, but I think that was just a one-off because I heard from others that they were pretty good at shipping tobaccos out. So we won't hold EA Carey too strong on that. I did order a vanilla custard. It's one of them. Just curious if their vanilla custard was different. It may have been the same thing. It didn't seem to be as strong or as pleasurable as my normal vanilla custard. Little side note. I think I took for granted that many of you are familiar with vanilla custard, and I just kind of glossed over it and talked about how wonderful it was, but I never really highlighted it. And I know I've said this in a number of videos before, vanilla custard smells like you're baking cookies. No joke, it smells like you got cookies in the oven. At least two or three times I've had that question asked. You got something in the oven? No. And that don't mean is it burning. They mean like, yum. So, when I ordered those four tobaccos and they came in, one of them just stood out. And at the time I was reading this children's book, and enjoyable book, I think I may have mentioned it at one point, it's called The Old Tobacco Shop. And I don't know if some of you have seen this before. Really fun little book. You can see the Punch, the cigar little mannequin there. And so the story kind of centers around this little boy being sent down to the tobacconist to pick up some tobacco for his father. And an adventure ensues, and all of a sudden he's going down to the tobacco shop on a regular basis, and at times even helping the shopkeeper. Well, there's one tobacco jar up on the wall that the shopkeeper talks about just how wonderful this jar was and how it's a mystery and how it's this magical tobacco that's inside of it. No, not that kind of mystery tobacco, but anyway, he talks about how wonderful the tobacco is in it, and how it nearly will just transport you into another realm, and how it will call up the old sailor who first brought the tobacco there. Well, I had just been reading the story, become so captivated by it, I had to have a jar like that. So, I discovered me a little jar just like the jar described in the book. And so, this is exactly as it's described in the book. The only difference is this is made out of cedar. So it's a cedar wood jar. Might change the tobacco slightly, but not that much. Right now, I filled my tobacco out of a pouch. So, what did I put in here? None other than English Oriental Supreme. Indeed. Peter Stokkebye, number 306. Now, the E.A. Carey just said English Oriental Supreme, or English Oriental, I believe. And their bulk prices just were a bit high for my taste. And so I thought, what is this? And I think it was one of you in the community who told me, well, that's Peter Stokkebye's blend. They're just repackaging it. Because that's kind of what it looked like to me, is that it was repackaged. So I ordered a couple of different Oriental Supremes, and the Peter Stokkebye really seemed to be the same as the E.A. Carey. So what is the English Oriental Supreme? Black Cavendish, Burley, Latakia, Oriental, Turkish, Virginia. It is a wonderful blend. It truly is supreme and a cut above the rest. Now, yes, you know I thoroughly enjoy my Old Professor, but this is a more of a Oriental blend to me, so I do get more of an Oriental mix off of it. I will say, I'm sorry I have to keep relighting. Normally, you know, when I'm not talking, my bowl's lit and it's going, and I thought you might understand me a little bit better if I don't have my pipe in my mouth. But it is a wonderful blend, and this is a wonderful pipe. I've smoked a lot of different tobaccos out of this pipe, and I was trying to figure out what would be dedicated to it. So on finding the Oriental Supreme, I decided that's what I would dedicate to this pipe. An unusual pipe, an unusual tobacco jar, or an unusual blend. If you've never read this book, I don't know if you can get it as an ebook or not. Maybe. No audiobook for it. I checked already. I was going to tell you that you could get it, but I didn't see it. Old book. Kind of a neat story. You can almost figure out how it's going to start unfolding about halfway through. Really, just a children's book. But I mean, I say children's. What do I think that is? Not like the old. Not like modern children's books. So, I know we're at the end. But it's not the end. I will have a few more videos scattered. I probably, at this point, I can't guarantee you, I'm going to aim for doing 2 a week. We just hit the tip of the iceberg for pipes. Kind of hit the tip of the iceberg for my tobaccos, but I don't really want to start breaking into aged tins, and especially rarities, just yet. But here's what I'm going to ask you to do. Tune back in tomorrow, because tomorrow I'm going to tell you what my next plan is. I already have a plan for the month of March, and I think you're going to enjoy it. I hope I'm going to enjoy it. It's going to involve more pipes for my collection, and it's going to involve more tobacco indeed. So check back in tomorrow, see that video. It'll be another short one. This one might be a little bit longer today because we're kind of finishing off the series. But I do thank you for all of your thumbs up, for your encouraging words, for those who said that you've really gotten used to seeing this every day. Well, brothers and sisters, sit back, load up a bowl, light up, enjoy your smoke. Until next time, God bless.